Hey everyone, SilentCiel here. Welcome back to another video with me, and this time round we are going to play the brand new game Pokemon Sun. So I got myself Pokemon Sun. I haven't gotten Moon yet because I'm still contemplating whether to obtain a Japanese cartridge of Pokemon Moon. I'm no rush to getting it. I have all the other games since Black and White. No, not Black and White, X and Y. So with like the main game that I'm playing in English and the sub game that I'm playing as Japanese cartridge, since I have both the Japanese and the English consoles of the 3DS. So yeah, it will help me a lot with the trading and all that. But this time around I went ahead and just obtained Sun first, so as to share my gaming experience with you guys. And yeah, I have not gotten my Moon game yet because I think there is no need for me to rush into it. So yeah, I'm just basically gonna play through Pokemon Sun for the story purpose, so that you guys can enjoy the game along with me. I won't be doing any videos of hardcore training and all that because I think that won't be necessary for my channel, because I don't think a lot of people want to see me like grinding for shinies or that kind of thing. Yeah, but if you guys are interested in seeing that kind of thing happen, then do let me know in the comments down below so that I can decide whether to do it or not. Alright, so let's get down to it. This is a brand new game, so I've just unboxed the game and slotted it in my cartridge and finally got it playing. I didn't do an unboxing because mine is just the regular edition of the game. In Singapore, we do not have the special editions of the Sun and Moon, like the Europe or the American side customers will get to purchase. So yeah, even in Japan they have this double Pokemon Sun and Moon box set, but there's really nothing special about the premium because there's just codes for 100 Pokeballs times 2, so 200 Pokeballs I think. So yeah, really nothing special. Alright, so as usual, for Pokemon I think it's fine to play in English because there's no real reason for me to change all the different languages, because I guess most of my viewers are English viewers. I do have some Japanese viewers here and there, but it's for certain games only, so I don't think I need to have Pokemon in Japanese. Right, so
oh, what's going on?
So apparently I have a phone call. What? Did the game just start straight away from after the language selection?
Oh, that's a first. This never happened before in any of the other games, I think.
I didn't really start Alpha Ruby and Omega Sapphire. So yeah, I'm still very slow on the Ruby and Sapphire storyline. Even though back then when Ruby and Sapphire were on the Game Boy Advance, I did not play that too. So it's the only Pokemon series game that I have not touched at all. Okay, yeah, so hang on now, give me a sec.
Hey there, good afternoon. So the day has finally come that you're moving to Alola. Alola is a region made up of several islands. That could be the reason the region is chock full of nothing but rare Pokemon. Yeah.
There's no shortage of cool Pokemon out here in Alola either.
Such mysterious creatures. You'll find them all over, in the grass, in the caves, in the sky and sea. Here in Alola, we love our Pokemon and we depend on them heaps too. Some of us even battle with them if we call ourselves Pokemon trainers.
Rockruff, I think that's how you pronounce his name.
Can you wait until I'm done talking to Clay?
You know, every time when I come across Pokemon series characters,
they never seem to be very rude, very polite, even when they're a bit upset. So even in anime, you seldom see characters being really very, very pissed off in Pokemon series, unlike other anime genres. So I would say this is probably one of the good things why parents still allow kids to watch Pokemon, because of their very G-rated genre or style. Yeah, so... Alright, I gotta ask you some questions about yourself so I can introduce you to everybody. So which photo should I use for your trainer passport?
So, alright,
I'm gonna go with the girl as usual. Probably for my moon game, I'll pick up the boy as my main character. I'm going with the dark hair one because she is the default look for the Pokemon Sun and Moon trailers. I'm Asian, so I'm pretty used to seeing girls with black hair or brown hair if they ever dye their hair. Yeah, so in my country, we don't really have a lot of blonde. And blonde hairs don't really pique my interest, I guess. But, you know, she's pretty cute too. For dark skin colored characters, we do have a lot of Indians and Malays in Singapore, so I'm pretty used to this as well. Because I'm Chinese. I'm not Japanese though. So yeah, I'm Chinese and yeah, I'm gonna stick with the Asian looking girl.
I gotta say the character designs are pretty cool though. I'm just gonna pick. Let's not delay anymore. So yes. Alright then, I'll let you spell out your name for me. So as a girl, definitely my name would be Cecile. So I'm gonna press this in. Don't mind my finger. C, type. Where's the caps? How do I caps? Oh, okay, so...
Sorry about that.
So yeah, sadly I don't have a screen recorder for my 3DS, so I won't be able to record both my upper and lower screen, so I'm just gonna mainly show you guys the upper screen. So
that's where the story goes in, and you guys can probably read the text by reading the box here. So yeah. Alright, so you go by S. Cecile, yes.
Ten-4, good buddy. I'll let everybody out here know you're on your way. Okay, my name. Yeah, that's a name that hits you like a thunderbolt out the sky.
Ooh! Okay, I'm very bad with narrating, so... yeah, I apologize for my bad narration. Can't wait to see you in person then, cousin. Huh, so apparently we are his cousin. Aren't we a bit too young to be the professor's cousin?
Maybe not, I guess.
And I guess in some countries, you know, there's an age gap of maybe 10 to 15 for cousins as well, I guess. In my country, we do have age gaps of, 8 to 10 or even more. Yeah, I guess so. Depending on how, when or where your aunts and uncles give birth to a new child, I guess.
So apparently we are related to the professor in some way. So this time around we are family members of the professor. Alright, so Cecile, come help me with these boxes. So here we go.
I never understood the Pokemon language, even in anime and even in games. You know, nobody actually... I don't think anybody actually translated the language of Pokemon World. Maybe there are, but I'm not familiar of anyone. I'm not familiar with whoever has actually done so. I haven't really gone deep into searching the language itself.
So what's going on here? If I'm not wrong, that lady is actually the assistant to the professor. So she's like carrying a bag full of the starter Pokemon, I guess. Kind of feels like X and Y. And the way you get your starter Pokemon. Alright, so that's how we get our title out. Alright, let me focus. 3 months later. So this part's probably a bit familiar to you, everyone, if you have actually played the Sun and Moon demo. Ah, can't you just feel that warmth? The first day spent under Alola's sun. It's so warm and bright here. But that's enough of that. Time to unpack all these boxes. So apparently in Alola, our Meowth is not Alola region Meowth, it's the standard Meowth, and apparently it's standing on two legs. If you guys remember, the first few Meowths that ever appeared, the Meowths were all on their paws. Only the Team Rocket's Meowth actually stood on two legs, so I guess they started to default the Meowths to stand on two legs. Oh yeah, Meowth, go get Cecile for me, would you? Okay, so as you can hear, Meowth's cry is definitely the same as all the video games. I think Pikachu is the only one that actually retained its anime voice. I remember Pikachu did have its own video game sound, but ever since Pikachu became popular in the anime, I guess they decided to change it with the Pikachu voice actress. Why do we sleep on our bed with shoes? Okay, that's just a bit strange for me, especially in our Asian countries. We don't walk around our house with shoes on, so yeah, this is a bit strange to me. Oh, a Pikachu doll. Adventure rule number one. Open the X menu with the X button. Okay, so the menu is now called X menu. Alright, adventure number two. Record your progress with save. So they're asking me to save my game. Okay, so I shall do just that. So I'm gonna save. Yes. So saving, save done. Alright. So is that a Nintendo Switch? Oh no, it's a Wii U. If only it was a Nintendo Switch. Alright, it's a Wii U. It has a gamepad with a screen. Alright. I want this Ditto pillow. Oh my god, the poor Ditto pillow. Abused by Meowth. That's a pretty nice house. Oh, I forgot to narrate that.
So sorry. Alright, so Cecile, are you pumped to meet some Alolan Pokemon? Honestly, I'm not too sure because the designs for Pokemon Sun and Moon kind of put me in a weird place, yeah. Oh, you. Someday you're going to learn to have a little wonder in your life. We're living in the Alola region now, the beautiful islands everyone wants to visit. Huh. I'm sure the Pokemon living in a place like this must be friendly, right?
Was that the doorbell?
That's got to be Professor Kukui. Did I get his name correct? Hey. Why don't you let him in, Cecile? Meowth is so tiny.
Okay, so she's gonna repeat the same thing as one huge ass TV.
There are mounds of Malasada waiting for you. Join us to enjoy some marvelous Malasada. What in the world is a Malasada? Okay.
Oh my goodness, are they like seeing? Oh, there's an advertisement?
So, is he like saying it in an Australian accent?
Oh my goodness. They're making me hungry.
Okay, this is not the door to the exit of the house. Meowth's bed. So what's the point of buying it? A waste of money.
Wow.
So like the mom has only like one kind of dress design. And only two types of patterns on it. So our cousin is here.
Hey there, Cecile. The name's Cookie. Good to meet you, cousin. Why do you need to introduce yourself to your own cousin? Okay, never mind.
You gotta be tired after that long trip all the way out here to Alola. You feeling any jet lag?
We sure are a long way from Kanto out here in Alola.
So apparently we are from Kanto, which is where Ash came from. So Ash in the anime is going to Alola, but I'm not so sure whether he is moving to Alola like the game characters here. He is playing the part of Sun, which is the main male character. So, is this a hint to the anime series where Ash and his mom are going to move to Alola?
We'll see when anime airs. It's still daytime out here, yeah? So yeah, there is some time difference for the game for Pokemon Sun and Moon, so...
Professor Kukui, yes, we just arrived yesterday.
Hey there, Mom. Wait. What in the world? I really don't understand right now.
So why is Kukui asking my mom to call her why is he calling my mom, Mom? What in the world is going on? I have no idea on this family relationship. Oh my goodness. Welcome to Alola.
Of course, I still remember seeing you battle in the Indigo Gym Leaders back in Kanto all those years ago, you know?
So apparently the professor has been to Kanto.
I've been in love with Alolan Pokemon ever since, so I finally decided to come here myself. I was supposed to be visiting there to research Kanto Pokemon moves and all.
I thought I knew a thing or two about battling, but those Kanto gym leaders proved me wrong.
So I wonder which gym leader will possess.
Hey now, Cecile. Let's get a move on to the next town over, cousin. Is he saying cousin as slang or I don't know. Are we really related with him? Time for you to meet the island Kahuna
and get yourself a Pokemon, yeah? Kahuna?
Sure, the Kahunas are crazy strong Pokemon trainers here in Alola. Cousin.
Why does he keep saying cousin? So I guess Kahunas are gym leaders here?
I guess since they are unbeatable for folks like me and you. And the Kahuna who lives in Iki Town is...
Did I get it right?
Iki? I guess so. Always happy to give any kid who wants to have an adventure their first Pokemon, yeah? Okay, that's some strange English. Have an adventure their first Pokemon, yeah, that's some strange English. Okay.
They'll simply give my girl a Pokemon? Then those Kahunas already are worth meeting. Hurry and get ready, Cecile. You're back and head.
So yeah, my hat. And things are still in the boxes in your room, I think. You think? And didn't you leave your copy of Adventure Rules on your desk in there too? Yeah, the one that your dad apparently wrote for you, I guess. So where is my dad?
Oh, I bet you've got a styling hat that will match mine, yeah?
Okay, so we're gonna find our stuff. That's true, when did she buy it? We just moved here, right? Let's take a look at the whole house.
It's a pretty nice house.
I wonder how much it costs. Nice shoes.
I like that beanie. That's a really tiny Meowth though.
You look ready for anything now. Have a good time out there. I'll be sure to have everything cleaned up and put away by the time you come back with your new Pokemon. Are those glasses on my head? Yeah, I guess so. Because the ahoge or their hair antennas on the mom's head really makes it look different. Woo, that's a styling hat, cousin. Why does he keep saying cousin? Oh my god. Your mom there, she sure's looking forward to you getting your first Pokemon, yeah? So let's get going to Iki Town. Time for you to get a real nice Pokemon from the island Kahuna. Oh yeah.
I should say that. Oh yeah.
Alright, let's go get our Pokemon. The soundtrack's pretty cute. Hey now, the heat getting to you? I said we go this way. How in the world will I know where do you go? Can I just go here? No, apparently you won't let me go there. Okay, I'm going this way.
Now this is more like it, yeah?
Welcome to Paradise, cousin. This is the Alola region. Folks here in Alola get along by living together with Pokemon and working together too. After all, you can go anywhere, yeah, as long as you got Pokemon helping you out here. That's why we gotta get you to the kahuna. First, we're off to Ikitown. Come on, it's not far if we cut up here. You know, the name Iki kind of reminds me a lot of Metabots, you know, where the main character is named Iki.
Okay, so apparently this is a slope to jump down from, loving the camera angle.
Let's talk to this strange dude that's staring at us. The power of science is amazing. Simple press of a button and you can trade Pokemon or battle with people around you. So I guess he's talking about the online system.
Okay, we should run. Here we are.
Seriously, we are just like down the slope from Iki Town. Alright, so Cecil, you're loving Alola already, yeah? Yeah, pretty much. I like the scenery. That's what I like to hear. The more you love Alola, the happier I'll be. Hmm. Oh yeah, look there. Looks like an excited Alolan trainer come to us. Professor Kukui, you've got to recommend another move for me sometime, please. Why? You already know which moves you want to use, yeah? You come find me the next time your Pokemon learns a new move and I'll battle you. So this is like the first ever professor to battle a trainer, I guess? I don't recall any professors out there who actually fight trainers. See that if you wait, there is. I completely forgot about the X and Y professor. See that if you had a Pokemon with you, you could dive into the tall grass here, yeah, to try to catch some wild Pokemon to add to your team. So as usual, in all Pokemon games, we aren't allowed into the grass until we have our own Pokemon. Then trainers go up against one another in battle with the Pokemon they love. Come on, Yungoos. How do I pronounce that? Heck out that name. Yungoos, I guess. So that's our first look at the Alolan Meowth. How's it? You're the new kid, just flew in? Let's have a Pokemon battle sometime. Having Pokemon gives you a whole new way to communicate with other people, see? Let's get moving, Iki Town is right over there. And we're here! This right here is Iki Town. This town is where folks come to worship the Pokemon that watches over Mele Mele Island, what in the world? Did I get that right? Tapu Koko keeps us all safe and happy. Oh my goodness, all these tribal names, I just cannot get to... it doesn't stick with me. Oh boy. Huh? What's going on here? We were supposed to meet everybody right here, yeah? Maybe they're all back there on Mahalo Trail? That's where the ruins of our guardian deity Tapu Koko are. Yeah. I'm really wondering what his English voice acting will be like. Oh my goodness. Cecil, do me a solid and go find the island kahuna. I'll wait around here to make sure we don't miss each other.
The island kahuna?
You can't miss him. He looks just like a kahuna. What in the world does a kahuna look like? Okay, so we're supposed to find something that we don't have a clue what it will look like. Just having Pokemon on your side makes you feel all warm inside, doesn't it? Eating dinner together, playing together, enjoying spending time together. That's a lot of togethers in one whole sentence. It's pure happiness.
Okay.
I think I probably should just narrate all the main story plots. It's just funny to always see Pokemon games allowing us, the main character, enter into other people's homes just like that, and they are not angry about it. Really? You want to go up to the ruins? I don't know what you hope to find there.
It's a pretty big stage.
Kahuna Hala is the strongest Pokemon trainer of all of Milimili. But I guess he must be off helping someone train right now. I don't see him anywhere. Okay, so I guess that's like the gym. On sunny days like this, I do like to just wander around following the wind, don't you? The ruins of conflict? Oh my goodness, that sounds so ominous. What mysterious creatures? Pokemon sometimes leap right out of the grass to help people in trouble, did you know? That's true. I've never seen that happen in a game before. You can't come out. You'll get in trouble if anyone sees you. So why in the world is she hiding? I know they are the three starters, but why are they hiding them? Okay, so somehow or other the Tiki design kind of reminds me like the mob villains from the Kamen Rider series.
Oh my goodness, it's not the starter. Immediately after it comes out, it gets attacked. So it's confused. It has birds flying over its head. Alright, so let's go help her out.
What's wrong? Help! Save Nebby!
Those sparrows are attacking it,
but I'm too afraid to go out there. My legs feel like they might give out.
Yeah, I wouldn't get on the bridge either.
Oh my goodness, why do they have to... Oh no, no, no. What in the world? So I guess I had to walk slow. So how are we gonna help this thing when we don't have a Pokemon?
Oh my goodness, he just sent us falling.
Oh, thank goodness. You tried using your power again, didn't you? Oh, Nebby. You know what happened the last time you used it? You couldn't move for ages after that. I don't want to see you like that again. No, I shouldn't say that. I'm sorry, Nebby. I know you were trying to save me at that time. And I couldn't even help you in return.
She's so mysterious, oh my goodness.
What? What is that?
It just pooped. Shiny poop.
A sparkling stone? It feels almost warm somehow. It's poop, I tell you, it's poop! Please forgive me. I'm so grateful to you for helping us out of that dangerous spot. Are you the kahuna? I think this stone must belong to you. I don't want the poop! Throw the poop away!
Oh my goodness, we just took poop. Sparkling stone.
You open up the key items pocket and put the sparkling stone away inside. Please, don't tell anyone about this, about seeing Nebby. It's a secret, okay? So, is it like some kind of legendary?
Come on, into the bag, Nebby.
I'm worried we might get attacked again by some wild Pokemon or something. I know it's too much for me to ask it, but do you think you could see us back to town?
Sure, why not?
I mean, what other choice do we have? Okay, so let's send her back to town.
More like a village, right?
It's kind of small to be a town. Loving the music. Hey, Cecil, looks like you missed the kahuna, yeah? But you found my assistant. Oh, yeah. Looks like you already met. But just in case, this is my assistant. Oh, yes, you can call me Lily. And Lily, this here is Cecil. She just moved here to Alola.
Take good care of her.
It seems like it's the other way around. So you're also one of the professor's acquaintances. Nice to meet you. The kahuna is back. Kahuna Hala has returned. Our guardian's chosen one is back. Only one of the strongest Pokemon users in Alola, yeah? Why does everyone say yeah here? Did he steal my mom's dress to make that coat? Have I missed something? Nah, but where you go off to, Kahuna? I thought we were meeting here. I am kahuna of this island after all, so I can go anywhere. Whenever there is a problem on the island, it is my duty to resolve it. Sorry, Lily. What were you saying before? For some reason, I thought I saw Tapu Koko flying about. So that yellow lightning Pokemon thingy was... Okay. Yes, Kahuna Hala. Maybe it was being attacked by Spiro on the plank bridge when this girl helped it get away.
But the bridge collapsed
and I thought both of them might fall to the bottom of the ravine. And that was when the island's guardian deity swooped in to save them. Whoa, that's something you don't hear every day. Although it is said to protect us, our Tapu Koko is a rather fickle creature. Tapu Koko, sorry. Yet our guardian has moved to save you. Kukui, my boy. I think we have cause to celebrate. It seems I should entrust this brave and kind young girl with a Pokemon of her own. We'll make a fine trainer of her. I'm glad to meet you, child. I am Hala, the kahuna of Mili Mili Island. Welcome to Alola. Young Kukui had told me of your coming. I'm glad we got the chance to meet today. Come, my Pokemon, let's have a look at you. Finally, we are getting our starters. This is so exciting. So, which one you guys think I will pick? First is the grass-type Pokemon, Rowlet. Next is the fire-type Pokemon, Litten. And last is the water-type Pokemon, Popplio. Which Pokemon will you choose as your partner? So which one do you guys think I will choose? Popplio? Nah. I'm actually a Team Rowlet. Only when you have both chosen each other can you truly call each other partners. Ah, it's so cute. Can I don't evolve him? So let's see if Rowlet there also decides to choose you. Staring into each other's eyes. Why do you shake your head? No. Aww. Oh my god, it's like the size of my head. Oh, I forgot to read. Having accepted one another, you surely be friends for life. Nah, I'm not gonna give him a nickname. I wonder if mine is a female. Nice to meet you, Rowlet. Oh, when do you get out again? I know that Kahuna Hala and the professor will keep you safe from any harm, but you should stay in the bag and out of sight. It's safer that way. I think you chose a wonderful Pokemon. But you didn't seem very excited about it when I chose Rowlet. Did you see her face back then? I think you chose a wonderful Pokemon. Please take good care of it. That's it, Cecile. Now that you've got a Pokemon, you're a real Pokemon trainer, yeah? And here's a lovely gift from me to help it make it special, cousin. So am I really his cousin? Okay, so we got a Pokedex. Pokedex is a real high-tech kind of tool, yeah, that can automatically record facts about any Pokemon that you meet. Your new partner, Rowlet, is already registered. Oh yeah, so check it out. What in the world is that? And this is a trainer passport that I had put together for you. So, no more Pokemon ID, it's called a passport, I guess. Now, why don't you introduce your new friend to your mom, Cecile? Alright, so back home it is. Alright, let's head home. This way, I guess. Ah, so enters the rival. Hey, you and me, let's have a Pokemon battle. Where's the fire boy? What kind of Pokemon battle would that be where you don't even give a name per se?
Fair enough then, I'm Hao and my partner's Pleo.
Your Rowlet looks really cool too.
You like Pokemon?
Yeah, so let's battle!
Couldn't wait for you to find your way to Icky Town,
so I've been all over looking for Stalker! I don't really like to see Pokemon battles where Pokemon can get hurt, but I'll watch for you. Huh?
Oh yeah, your first
battle already?
Just have your Pokemon dish out some moves and see who wins.
Ooh.
I appreciate you being willing to take on my grandson. What? You're related? How in the world?
I expect a no-holds-barred battle from the both of you.
Alright, so our first Pokemon battle.
That's some very hippish battle soundtrack.
Oh wow, so okay, Alright, I'm gonna test out and see how much damage a tackle does. I guess I should have done it in the first few strikes. Because now that I got affected by growl, my attack is lowered. Oh boy. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave age lethargy. I have no idea how you wanna pronounce that.
There we go, level up.
Oh, I forgot to check our gender for Rowlet. Wait, was it male? I couldn't remember, I didn't really pay attention to the logo. Hui, that gave me chicken skin. What in the world? Cecile, right? Your Rowlet was awesome!
Now that settles it, I'm going all out tomorrow.
Cecile? Would you be so kind as to give me a look at that sparkling stone you have there? Is it the stone to have put on your Zack bracelet? I guess so. Could it be? Tutu, isn't that? You were rescued by Tapu Koko at the bridge, isn't that what I heard, Cecile? Yeah, rescued me. So even deign to give you a stone? Perhaps you are here in Alola, Cecile, because this is where you are meant to be. Allow me to borrow this stone for you now.
What?
Fret not, I'll return it to you tomorrow evening. It would seem that you have the makings of a fine trainer. You must do us the honor of joining in our festival tomorrow. First, I'll make sure you get back home safe today though, Cecile. Really, you two should come with us too, yeah? Wouldn't want to go losing you twice in one day, you and that precious Pokemon of yours. Yes, I will keep an eye on. Oh, you, would you not try to escape the very moment that you were told not to wander off?
Welcome back, Cecil.
So, what kind of Pokemon did you get? Don't keep me waiting. Oh, I think I'm falling in love. So why did you choose this sweet card?
Because it's cute.
Well then, you picked right, because I'll say this little charmer is definitely cute and cool.
The two of you look great together.
Yeah, matching pants with his green bow. I feel happier just looking at the pair of you. The next day.
What a stunning sunset.
Alright, today's the day I finally unpack. I guess not. Was that the doorbell? Go see who it is, Cecil. Why do people keep barging in before I even open the door? Damn you, man. So rude. Hey there, Cecil. It's about time we set out for the festival, yeah?
But first,
now that you're a real Pokemon trainer with your own Pokemon and all, I've got to show you something. Come with me out to Route 1. So I guess he's gonna show us how to catch Pokemon. Have fun at the festival, sweetie. I'm sure you have a good time with your new Pokemon pal. Me and Meowth will be sure to unpack every last box here you see. Power Mom.
Alright, out we go. Alright, I need to check. Oh.
Cecil, hurry it up, cousin. Pretend you're a Pokemon and use your agility. Agility!
Alright, so Popplio is... Rowlet is...
Rowlet is... Hasty? Rowlet is male! Oh my goodness, it's male! Okay, it's fine. I usually get my Pokemon all female though. It's fine. I guess we probably could breed Rowlet in the future. Yeah. Yeah, over here. Yeah, so it's gonna be the training on how to catch Pokemon. So you know that wild Pokemon will sometimes jump out at you in tall grass, yeah? Now that you've got Rowlet here, you can not only fight a Pokemon, yeah? You can also try to catch them. Woo! I'm going to show you how to catch a wild Pokemon, alright? Keep your eyes on the prize.
The thing I don't really like about the new Sun and Moon game is that the animation for capturing a Pokemon is very long.
So imagine if you're catching legendaries, especially for me, I always catch my legendaries in Pokeballs. It's gonna take forever for the animation to go through. Oh my goodness. Oh yeah! All Pokemon do sometimes attack people if they get close, but catch them and they'll join your team and be a great help to you, yeah? But if Pokemon get all tuckered out by fighting for you, just head home for a bit. If you ask your mom, I'm sure she'll let you and your whole team rest up at home. Or you could use some potions. Here's some Pokeballs and potions to get you started.
You open item pocket and put Pokeballs away inside.
Why don't you have a little adventure of your own on the way to Iki Town, yeah? Take good care of Cecil, Rowlet.
I wonder who's he talking to, Rowlet's in the Pokeball.
Okay, so I'm gonna end my adventure for part 1 of Pokemon Sun here. Do take a look again with me.
Or rather, keep a lookout actually.
With me for part 2, where we'll adventure to Iki Town and probably head over to fight our first gym, I suppose. I guess they're not called gym in this game since, I guess they changed the formats of Pokemon from the entire series with Sun and Moon. So Sun and Moon will definitely be a fresh new start for the Pokemon adventures from here on out. And
I'll see you guys soon in the next part.
Bye!